Everyone, it's Professor IB Bonkers here, and I'm so excited because we've got a special guest in the science lab. It's Amanda. Come on, Amanda, how are you doing?
I'm thrilled to be doing VKids from your lab today.
Isn't it so fun? Because we're on our second week of Advent, aren't we? So last week we learnt all about hope, and this week we're learning all about light. So I'm really excited about that. Are you excited, Amanda?
I'm excited, and I think you're the perfect person to teach us about light.
Thank you very much, I agree. Now, we're going to go to the challenge room first, though, because we need to find out what's going to be happening in the challenge today. So let's go and see.
Welcome, VKids, to another challenge round with Amanda
versus Professor Bonkers.
I'm excited to have a new challenge partner in the studio today. Professor Bonkers, we've got a really fun, I almost said experiment. We've got a really fun challenge.
Tell me what's going on here. I've got a sword.
Oh, no.
Hang on a minute.
We've got a sword challenge today. So basically what we're going to do is we're gonna throw the ball above head height. We have to tap it with the sword, then catch it with our hand.
Oh dear, right.
It's a lot of coordination. So we're each gonna get 5 attempts to do this. We'll take a turn.
Yeah.
But if you catch it on the first attempt, then that means you win.
Oh, so, great, and what happens to the loser?
No, that's a
Amanda.
Surprise,
oh,
Professor
right.
Bonkers.
It's exciting, isn't it? Mm-hmm. Love a surprise.
So as my guest today on the challenge,
right.
I'm gonna let you go first.
Oh, thanks so much. Right, here we go, I've got my sword. All right, above my head, you say?
Higher than your head.
Okay, here we go. Oh dear, wait right there.
Here we go.
Oh, no!
I really didn't think I was going to get that.
She's only gone and done it, VKids.
That means I'm the winner of this challenge today, Professor Bonkers. I hope to have you as a guest again.
But
you knew it was coming. Professor Bonkers, it's my honor and privilege to crown you with the Santa pants.
Well, I have to say that Amanda seems to win these quite a lot, so I'm wondering if she actually practices a bit. Anyway, I suppose I'm wearing this for the rest of VKids today, but we'll see what the story is with Granny Page Turner.
Bye.
See you later. Oh, hello, dears. Is that the VKids? It's the VKids. Hello, VKids. Granny Page Turner here. It's so wonderful to have you join us on the second Sunday in Advent. And today, we're learning all about light, aren't we? That Jesus is the light of the world. So in our story, we're going to learn about when Jesus was born. So let's all watch the story together now.
Stories of the Bible. Mary and Joseph. This is Mary.
Hi!
You see, Mary was the mother of Jesus, but before that happened, she lived in the town of Nazareth. Mary had no children because she lived according to God's law and had never been married.
Oops!
But she was engaged to marry a man named Joseph.
Heyo!
Hi, Joseph!
One day, an angel came to Mary and said,
Hi.
That God had chosen Mary. The angel said, God is with you. But Mary was afraid and confused.
Huh?
She wondered what the angel was talking about. Then the angel said, Don't be afraid. God loves you and wants to use you in a great way.
Me?
You will give birth to a son, and you will name him Jesus. He will be very great, and he will be the king forever.
Hold on.
Mary asked, But how can this happen? For she was not married yet and knew that she couldn't have a child until she was married. But the angel told Mary that the Holy Spirit would make her pregnant.
Wow.
So that the baby born will be holy and will be called the Son of God.
Wow.
The angel reminded her that nothing is impossible with God. So Mary decided to trust God and all that He had planned for her. Before their wedding, Joseph found out that Mary was pregnant.
Wait, what?
He thought she had done something wrong. But Joseph was a man of God and decided to break off the engagement quietly so no one around town would think badly of Mary. While Joseph was thinking about all this, an angel appeared to him in a dream.
Hi?
The angel said, "Joseph, don't be afraid to take Mary as your wife."
Why?
The angel explained that Mary's baby was from God.
Wait, what?
The angel told Joseph that the baby's name would be Jesus, and he would save his people from their sins.
Oh, wow.
And when Joseph woke up, he did as the angel told him.
Hi.
You right?
Really? Yeah!
And took Mary as his wife, while she was still pregnant with a son of God. And so Joseph and Mary trusted in God, and the two followed the plan that God had given them to help bring the Savior into the world. Stories of the Bible. Jesus is born. This is Mary.
Hi.
You see, Mary was the mother of Jesus, but before that happened, she lived in the town of Nazareth. And she was engaged to marry a man named Joseph.
Heyo.
Hi, Joseph.
Whew, got it.
Mary got pregnant by the power of God.
Wait, huh?
Joseph didn't understand all this at first, but an angel came and told him to still take Mary as his wife.
Yeah, okay.
So he did as the angel said. Not long after that, the ruler of the land, Caesar Augustus, wanted to count how many people were in the land. So Caesar Augustus ordered everyone in the land to travel back to their hometowns so that they could be counted. Joseph's hometown was Bethlehem, so Mary and Joseph traveled from Nazareth all the way to Bethlehem. When they arrived in Bethlehem, they looked for a place to stay.
No, I'm sorry.
Oh, man.
But there was no room for them.
What about there?
Okay.
So they stayed in a barn, and while they were there, Mary gave birth to Jesus.
Whoa.
She wrapped him snugly in the strips of cloth.
That'll work.
And laid him in a manger.
Excuse me.
And so the Son of God, the Savior of the world, was born in a barn in Bethlehem.
Oh, I think it might be time for a cup of tea, don't you, dears? Right, let's see what we've got. A nice English breakfast, I think. Pop it in the pot. Oh, here we go, lovely. Oh, it's the doorbell. Oh, I do hope it's Carrie Kate again.
Hi, Granny Kate.
Oh, Carrie Kate. So
here are your parcels.
Wonderful. Oh, thank you, dear.
It's a hefty bunch today.
Yes, I'm ordering a few more. Oh, there we go, dear. How are you?
I'm great.
Oh,
busy.
Good. Yes. Well, you know, I've had a terrible time, but I'll tell you about it over a cup of tea if you
sure.
can stay.
I think I got some time.
Wonderful, dear. Here we go. Would you like any sugar?
Yes, please. Heaps and heaps.
We don't have any. Sorry.
Oh.
I don't put sugar in my tea in England.
Okay.
There we go,
thank
dear.
You.
Lovely. So I've got to tell you, I had such a terrible week because we had a power cut. I couldn't see. I couldn't even find my teapot.
Oh, no.
Yes. Oh, no, indeed. It was an absolute disaster.
Wow.
But I had to find some candles, and I found them. I had to find some matches. Anyway, then I ordered a flashlight.
Oh, so, maybe it's in one of these boxes.
Yes, I do hope it is, dear, because the light will really help me to see in the dark, won't it?
Absolutely, and I need to maybe bring some more light to the other neighbors
yes.
in my packages.
Yes, maybe you've got some in your packages.
Yes, you never know.
Yeah, well, dear, it was
all
lovely
right.
to have you around.
Again.
I'll
yes.
see you very soon.
Bye.
All right.
See
ya. Bye, Kate. Bye, dear.
Well, Professor Ivy Bonkers, this is the bit I've been most excited about, is to see how you're going to apply the Advent theme of light to
yeah.
a solo cup, a piece of paper.
Yeah, just you wait, Amanda. I tell you, it's going to be really fun. Because
so
what we're going to do, we're going to do a craft. We're actually going to make a lighthouse, and you guys can make this at home as well if you want to. You might have all these things at home. Because you know, Amanda, a lighthouse, it shines light in the darkness, doesn't it? And that's like in our story, Jesus is the light of the world. So, you know when it's dark and you put the light on, the darkness has to disappear, doesn't it? Because the light's gone on, so the light is in that room, so it's not dark anymore. And that's what it's like when we have Jesus in our lives, you know, and we can shine
that's
his
true.
Light as well. We can show the light of him to our friends and our family, can't we? So, I'm going to show us how to make a lighthouse. All right. So, and this might also remind you, VKids, of the song My Lighthouse, because that says shining in the darkness, doesn't it? And it reminds us that Jesus shines in the darkness. He's the light of the world. Right, so you've got your red cup there. What's it called, Amanda?
A solo cup.
We don't have those in Northern England, so I have to ask her. Right, Amanda, what I'd like you to do while I'm doing something here is I want you to cut out some little squares of this black paper, because we're going to make them into the windows.
Okay.
So just little squares. And what I'm going to do while you're doing that, now we've come across an issue here because I've only got one pair of scissors, but I've got some black tape, and this is going to be the base of your lighthouse. Okay, so the black tape is just going to go round, just going to tape it all the way around. Here we go. Right. Now, Amanda, I wonder if you could just cut
yes.
that for me. Thanks so much. She's a really helpful assistant. Thanks, Amanda. Right, so we've got one. We're going to do another one. There we go. A little bit higher up on our lighthouse. There we go. No, thanks very much, Amanda. There we go, around the back. And then you can cut that tape. Perfect. Right. Now, I'm going to do one more. Oh, good, you've done. What else you can do, Amanda, is we also need a little black piece of paper to fit into our clear cup there. It's just going to sort of stick in the top there. Mm. So if you could do that for me, that would be great. While I just do this last bit of the lighthouse here. Take it all the way around. There we go. I can see you're concentrating really hard on that, Amanda. That's great. Lovely. Very nice, very good circle. Better than I could do, that's for sure. Perfect, now I'd like you just to do a little, that's it, lovely. Now, here's what we're gonna do next. We're going to, these are gonna be our windows. So we're just gonna stick some windows just round about the front. So I've got, we can either stick them in like this under our tape. So we've just got a few little windows, thank you. There we go, might put one there. That's it. Lovely. Put one up there, maybe. Oh dear, not sticking that one. Won't put one there, actually. I'm just going to put another one down here, like that. You can put as many windows as you like. Okay, Amanda, now, let's see if we can stick this in. We might need to do some tape. What I might do is just, if you've got glue dots at home, that would really work really well for this, wouldn't it? But we couldn't find any, could we?
Right.
Oh dear. Right, so we're going to stick that there. See if you can stick it in the top. That's it, a bit tricky. Well done, Amanda. That's lovely. Right. So, we've nearly done our whole lighthouse. But, what's missing? The light! Absolutely! We've got to have light, haven't we, Amanda?
Most important thing.
Yeah, right. So, we're going to switch the light on. There we go. It's flickering a little bit. Definitely don't use a real candle in this, okay? And then we've got the top of our lighthouse, and there you go. So when you make this at home, you can then switch the lights off and you can see your lighthouse shining a light in the darkness. And that can remind them all, Amanda, that Jesus is the light in the darkness and he's the light of the whole world, isn't he? Are you going to make one of these at home, Amanda?
I love this. Yeah. This is really a project I want to have at my house during the holidays.
Yeah, it's really fun, isn't it? Well, anyway, I hope you enjoy making that at home and we'll see you very soon. All right, bye!
Well, VKids, I love learning about Jesus, the light of the world, and I bet our friend Hamilton has a verse that he can tell us that will help us remember what Jesus says about him being the light in the darkness. So let's go over to Hamilton's house, which has been brilliantly decorated for Christmas, and see if he can give us a verse that we can keep in our heart.
Hello, VKids. Welcome back to my snowy cabin. I'm having so much fun learning all about Advent with you all. And today we've got our memory verse, and it's from John 8, verse 12. And this is Jesus, and he's saying, I am the light of the world. Whoever follows me will never walk in darkness, but will have the light of life. And it's just like Professor Bonkers was just saying, Jesus can be our light and our guide, and we can show his light and love to others when we ask him into our hearts. And you know, we can tell others all about him too. So I'll see you very soon. Bye.
Well, Amanda, you're absolutely right about Hamilton's house, weren't you, with all his decorations? I can't believe it. I need to get him round to mine for sure. Now, I want to go into some worship time now, Amanda, do you?
Yes.
Because I'm really excited to learn all about how Jesus is the light of the world. So, I want to do our Joy to the World song, but I think that I might need to be a bit more warmed up because I've been in the science lab all day. So, what do you think we should do?
I think we should go see our friend Jenny.
Yeah, Jenny. Oh.
She always has lots of enthusiasm.
She's an enthusiastic lady, is Jenny, isn't she? So let's go to Australia and see if she's there. Are you there, Jenny? Oh, hey guys. Jenny Jogslot here, just out in Melbourne, Australia. Now, I'm going to teach you all of the actions to Joy to the World, because on our Christmas Eve VKids family service, we're all going to do that together, okay? So, some of you might remember from the last few years, but I'm just going to go over all of the actions. So you might remember, you guys actually made up these actions. So it goes, Joy to the World, the Lord has come, let earth receive her King. And then my favorite bit, let every heart, so you're pointing at everyone, let every heart prepare him room. And then we go, let heaven and nature sing, let heaven and nature sing, let heaven and nature sing. That's it, yes, and then we carry on, don't we? All right, you guys, I think you've got it. So we are gonna go into our warm up. Before we do that, so I think we need to do our jogging, because what's my name? Yes, Jenny jogs a lot, so I do like to jog a lot. Okay, so we're gonna do 10 seconds of jogging. Here we go, are you ready? Everyone standing up? All right. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Amazing job, you guys. Let's all worship together.
See you.
Well, VKids, that's one of my favorite songs. And for all of those who are gonna be joining us in person, we're gonna be doing that on church on Christmas Eve. So I hope to see you there. Thank you so much for being with us today and learning all about Jesus being the light of the world. And I'm getting excited for Christmas. Are you?
I'm so excited for Christmas, Amanda. It's not that long, is it?
No.
Wow.
What's on your list, Professor Bonkers?
Oh, I've got all sorts. Some beakers, some jars, I need some new test tubes for my lab. I'd quite like this fancy telescope, but I think it's, you know, it might be a bit too expensive for Santa, so I'll might have to save that for next year.
I heard he has deep pockets, so
yeah.
Maybe you put it on
your list. I'll put it on my list. I'll put it on my list, yeah.
He might not be happy that you stole his pants, though.
I know. I can't really wait to take this off, to be honest. It's quite heavy on my head, and it's messing up my hair. You know, my hair normally looks really good, doesn't it?
Yeah, it really does.
Yeah.
I'm actually sometimes envious of how good your hair
I know,
actually looks.
I know. You're not the only one.
It's a style. All right, V-Kids. We'll see you next time. Bye.
Bye.